Foosball?
Foosball.
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 Foosball?
Foosball.
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 That would be a good, like, Will Ferrell reality comedy thing to do for him to enter the National Spelling Bee. You know? Like the Nationals. So he'd be on television and they'd give him a word.
He's like, he would just drag that out. And he would get it wrong,
and
but then he'd like...
Ideally, he would win and get the scholarship to college. Rub it in all the kids' faces.
Right, and then tear it up. I don't need this. I'm rich. That's good stuff.
That
yeah. I think at the end, he would have to like grab the mic off the stand because they never hold it and then drop it.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm 52 and I just beat y'all.
Suckers.
He's so much for you.
He's got his smartphone out like the whole time.
Yeah. You can clearly see an earpiece in his ear and he's like, Siri, spell. What did you just say? Nothing. I didn't say anything. You got hearing problems?
That would probably be better than most Saturday Night Live skits right there, what we just described.
Yeah. These days. Ooh, make the kick.
Dark days for the Lorne Michaels.
Poor Lorne. Too bad.
Lorne.
Too bad he has all that money to comfort him.
Yeah, somehow he'll get through it.
Oh, that was a changeup.
That was 10 years in the making.
Hold the string. 10 years. And now, a play 10 years in the making.
Somehow that makes
sequel.
It better.
Yeah, this is a sequel to the movie Boy. It's called Shot. 10 years in. Same characters, same Foos characters. Are you trying to marshal me?
Marshal.
If only Bert was it Bert? What's it, Chris Berman? I would say somebody else.
The Schwab.
Sounds like it. If only he hadn't come up with that first. I like the way you said it better. What?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I can't stand it. I know you're playing it. I'm going to set it straight. Just want a game.
I don't remember the rest. Hey, I keep feeding you. I think these handles are stiffer than those. It's harder to move the guys to and fro for scoring purposes. Is there another reason to move the guys to and fro? Scoring purposes seems to be the main thing.
Gerbert! Rabble.
You're a rabble.
Our viewers sometimes can't hear us. It's just a lot of noisy makers coming by us.
That's true. There's been a lot of complaints.
So I feel like I should join in the rabble.
You want to? You just want to be part of the crowd. That was a pretty good combo sequence between you. You're like, I'm gonna kick it.
I didn't mean to spin it, it was an accident.
Oh, yeah. What is that kind of magic? Ye be spinning.
Cute!
So how are the smaller half clones of yourself doing? Are they still ill?
They lost their license to ill. Would you mind recovering them all? They got their license deal from these stories, but then they got revoked.
Got some of the illest sickness.
Oh yeah, this sickness is ill.
Yeah.
That cook coat is off the hook.
Coat hanger is off his hook.
Yeah, they went to school today.
That's good.
They both missed a full day, and the young one should have missed two, probably.
I think it was all hoax. I don't want to go to school, man.
I think it was hopped up on pixie sticks and chicken pot pie.
Goofballs.
Wait, is that a thing? Is there something called a goofball?
Probably. I don't know, all the street slang kids are using.
Listen, man.
For candies and
we were kids, we just called them smarties. Just to crush them up and snort them.
The best don't one. Give children bad ideas. You want to leave the door.
Best tasting snot on earth.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's distracted.
Foiled again. That's the twice baked potatoes reference as well. Mm-hmm. I think we need to go to TGI Fridays on that.
Big shout out to baked potatoes out there. Both twice and once baked.
And waiting to be baked for the first time.
Potatoes help me through a really tough time. I just wanted
to say thank you for the whole standby though, for all you've done. People like me. And also for the Irish. You know that you, without you, we wouldn't have Idaho potatoes. It's the only good potatoes anyway.
That's an old bad comedian joke. You know. All these terrible diseases almost wipe people out. Like, what almost killed the Irish? Potatoes.
Yeah. I thought your every comedian's joke was going to be, I'd like to thank, you know, whoever's misfortune or whatever for giving me some material. Because they all seem to say something like that at some point.
Yeah.
Except for Jerry Seinfeld. He doesn't say stuff like that.
The one I remember the most, which I feel like I've already mentioned at some point during our 100 plus episodes, is Daniel Tosh when he's talking about some guy jumped into a roller coaster area to get his lucky hat back.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
A ride came by and some girl.
It was Batman, the ride, yeah.
Was it?
Yeah, I think it was not the one in Cali. I think it was the one in Florida.
So he went to get his lucky hat and then apparently decapitated.
Yeah. He got
some, and it broke some girl's leg because it was her leg.
Yeah, she basically and punched it in his head.
So Daniel's was like, upon hearing this, it was horrific, but I thought, how am I going to make this as funny to everyone else as I find it?
Yeah, his bet on that is pretty good because he's like, the kid's like, I got to get my hat. And he's like, no, man, cut your losses. Just like signs and saying, no, direct. He's like, but did you see me in that?
You see how sweet I look in that hat? Yeah, it's so great. And then he's like, do you think he got his lucky hat?
I'd like to think he did. Yeah, that sequence is really good.
And then
that's one of his best sequences.
It really is. And then one of the best parts is his follow-up. He's like, imagine signing that girl's cast. It's like, how'd you break your leg? Well, he kicked a guy's head off. Alright.
That's rough.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite bits of his. I love when his things go more towards the clever and less towards the gross.
Yeah.
It's just hard to find because there's so much popularity in being gross.
Everybody else is gross.
Pretty much.
Gross is the coolest.
Like Louis C.K., clever, clever. Gross.
I listened to enough of this stuff, I go, you know, I just can't anymore because
as
genius as he is, he goes gross so fast.
Yeah.
And unexpectedly.
Exactly.
It's like, why did you sign up for this? I ain't paying for your special CD box set anymore and for you to sign it in person.
Yeah, but I know he is a... He would argue, you know, like, I'm like one of the most successful comedians there is out there, and I make a boatload of money.
Yeah. That's
exactly what I'm doing, so I'm gonna keep being gross. Yeah.
Doesn't mean I don't like you. No, here's a comedian I like.
Here's a guy.
Hey, here's a guy who doesn't like youfoos anymore.
I like it as much as I ever did.
Whoa!
That means a lot.
He's not going downhill, that's good.
Thank you.
Wow, I mean.
Ruth's Chris.
Wait, is his wife's name or is his mom named Ruth?
If he was gonna be our fourth, I was gonna break that out. But.
You guys wanna lay a steak on the table here?
Hey Chris, I need you that nickname. I'm Ruthless.
Ruthless. I don't have a Ruth, so I'm not Ruth's Chris.
Baby Ruth's Chris?
I'm Ruthless.
You see, Ruth's Chris is a steakhouse for people.
We have to explain the premise of the joke and where the places are. McDonald's is a yummy restaurant that I eat at every day. Off the table. We went
fish
that
out of
long.
Water.
I can't find it. It's over.
Old maid.
I saw a video where Major League Baseball, the
pitch came in, the guy swung at it and hit it into the dirt, and it popped up and stuck to the chest pad of the catcher. And he got up, like, looking for it. He couldn't find it, and it's just sitting there.
Right.
I was like, what? I hadn't seen that
before.
Was
there a guy on base?
I think there was, and so they were worried about stealing. But then he's just sitting there with his, like, hands up going, I don't know what to do.
Someone help me. Just got, like, the jaws of life, and they removed the catcher's head.
And then, the guy was out. Threw the guy out at third. I don't think that's how the game works. You should probably learn a little bit more about baseball before you talk about it.
Why are they always using the jaws of life on everyone?
That's it? You better. That's a multi-stage.